Hello and welcome back to the I-24 News Desk. North Korea has accused the United States of risking the uncontrollable phase of a nuclear war, threatening a merciless strike on the American mainland. Pyongyang fears the U.S.-South Korea joint military exercises starting Monday are the dry run for an invasion, but Washington and Seoul insist they are purely defensive. China and Russia have urged the U.S. to scrap those 10-day joint drills, which will include 17,500 U.S. service members. North Korea now claims it can miniaturize a nuclear warhead to fit on an intercontinental ballistic missile and claims its ICBMs can hit American territory. The American Secretaries of Defense and State are insisting the U.S. is keeping military options on the table for dealing with North Korea's nuclear threats. We're joined now from London by John Hemmings, director of the Asian Studies Center at the Henry Jackson Society. John, thank you for joining us. Outgoing White House strategist Steve Bannon claimed in this interview that in any scenario of war with North Korea, 10 million people would be killed in Seoul in the first 30 minutes from conventional weapons. Hyperbole, or does war with North Korea really mean Armageddon?
Well, it is a very serious, serious risk. I know this was weighed up by the Clinton administration in 1994, and they backed away from it very quickly when they looked at the war game scenarios. The fact that Seoul is within reach of artillery fire from the north, and that artillery is carefully placed under bunkers, inside caves, the terrain is mountainous. You know, this is not an open desert landscape in which enemy units are easily observed. So that, combined with the North Korean disregard for human life, seeming disregard, and their immense chemical weapons supply, would make any type of strike on both sides extremely catastrophic.
Is there a military option for North Korea, then?
The only military options that I can imagine would be deterrence, which plays into why the United States and South Korea want to press ahead with the Old Chief Freedom Guardian exercises. These were originally carried out after, in 1968, the North Koreans inserted a commando squad into Seoul to assassinate the South Korean president. And as a result, ever since, you know, the U.S. and South Koreans continue to defend themselves by carrying out these exercises.
John, how likely is it, particularly given the current president, that the U.S. and North Korea could accidentally stumble into a full-blown nuclear war?
I mean, that's the $10 million question. I think both sides are more in touch with rhetorical bellicosity than actual intention. You know, this president fires off very strongly worded tweets. We've all become accustomed to that. If you're just vaguely following North Korean politics, as people like me do, you know, they regularly threaten to turn Seoul into a sea of fire. You know, it's a very North Korean type of rhetoric. It's always high. And because the stakes are high on both sides, I still believe that they will not risk it to that level. It's just that the rhetoric has never been so high. And I believe that is because the ability for North Korea to strike the U.S. mainland has shifted the American strategic considerations, which is upping the North Korean game as well.
The nuclear clock ticking towards midnight. John Hemmings from London, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.
Well, the countdown is on. Only one day to go until all...